It's National Teen Driver Safety Week. Several factors can give young or inexperienced motorists issues on the road, such as driving at night or changing speeds. Inclement weather creates hazards on the roadways in the Heartland, whether it be rain or snow and ice. Sergeant Justin Dunn with Missouri State Highway Patrol shared tips for navigating those conditions.
You know, as those weather conditions persist and change, we want to be cognizant and fluent with those changes in our vehicle. We need to know how the vehicle mechanics are, how the braking system is going to work. We know that obviously if there's a lot of rain, there's a lot of water on the roadway, you could hydroplane, so we want to reduce our speeds. Same with ice and slush covered roadways. The car and the mechanics of the car operate differently in those type of situations. So a big thing is give yourself ample time to get to your destinations, give yourself more time, slow down. Take your time. Make sure you get your vehicle checked before those type of inclement weather conditions and the different seasons move into those patterns. Make sure you got good tires on the vehicle, good tread depth to be able to spread that water out through those grooves or that slush or snow. And then just know the proper mechanics on what they need to do if they're ever in a motor vehicle accident, what they should do, who they need to call, and where to go from there.
Luckily, Sergeant Dunn provided tips for those involved in a crash, no matter the severity or weather.
If they can and the vehicle is mobile, we need to move it out of the roadway to a safe location so that we don't have a secondary collision at that location, someone come up and cause another traffic crash. Then they need to call 911 if there is injuries. If not injuries, you can call your local highway patrol headquarters at star 55 on your cellular phone or 1-800-525-5555, and that'll get you in contact with the nearest troop headquarters, and they can send emergency personnel to their location. We always recommend that they stay in the vehicle. A lot of people want to get out of the vehicle and start walking around. With traffic coming through that area, there could be a secondary collision. They could actually end up hitting you being outside the vehicle, or worse, get killed or struck by another vehicle coming through that area. Your human instinct says, I want to get out of the car, I want to get away from it, but we always recommend you stay in the vehicle until we get emergency services there to render aid if you need it and get vehicles removed and tell you where to go to the safe location.